Hello, everybody.
I'm Roberto. I don't know a lot of people here. I'm happy to see new faces. I speak too fast. So please interrupt me if you don't understand something and you need me to repeat. Okay, we are giving a session about using Twig as a rendering system for Joomla extension. How many of you here know what Twig is? Ah, that's good. And how many of you are already using it? Because I'm talking about an extension that I created as a way to fix people already using Twig in different ways, integrating it in different extensions. So if I needed Twig in my extension, I included it, and then someone else needed it and included another version that maybe was the one version, the X version. So this is about it, and let's see how it goes. Those are the slides of the session, and the Twig repository, webpage, the Joomla Twig extension, which is the one that I created, and the last one is an extension that I have created to show how to integrate Twig into a sample module. This is me, I'm Roberto, I'm from Spain, I have three demos, and I mainly write PHP, and I'm now switching to React, like Ruben said, to switch interface and data. I'm a freelancer, I have contributed to Joomla, and I love open source, I have honey commercial extensions, but I have like 10 repositories of GitHub with stuff that I want people to use. And what is Twig? I happy that most of you already know it, so I'm going to do this fast and try to get to the code as fast as possible. Twig is a template engine created to easy things to frontenders, and it's some kind of language that gets transpiled or compiled to PHP code. It's something that is used outside, like in Symfony and other projects, Drupal. And it's easy to learn, there is a lot of documentation. It's fast because there is people caring about creating benchmarks and ensuring that it's still as fast as other competitors. You can extend it with functions and filters that we will see later. It's secure, everything is escaped by default. So if you have to break things, you have to put time on it, break it on purpose. Which is cool, and it's fully unit tested and documented. It has a great documentation, and you can ask, you can find questions for answers for the most common questions in places like Stack Overflow. Those are examples of host usage. The top one is a for statement. And you see it's quite easy to understand, it's like other markup and like Mustache, or if you have used things like Smarty or whatever, you will find it easy to learn. These are the main features from Twig. It allows you to create variables in your layouts and also change them, create them dynamically. The first thing is a variable named foo. Then you can create your own custom tags if you want something that isn't built, you can create it. I think most of the people won't need custom tags, but it's like the last step if you need something really powerful. You can create your own markup. Then there are functions, which are things that accept parameters, like the date function you see below. It's a function that creates a date object that you can compare with another date object to do something. Then there are filters that are supposed to filter already existing variables, like list, the list join thing will get an array and join it, comma separated. It also supports things like macros, like some kind of browsable stuff that you can include. It works pretty much like node import statements, so you can import them and give them parameters and use it. One of the key features for me and for Joomla developers is that it supports inheritance, so you can extend and layout, change whatever you need, and you have like your component view or your main module wrapper, and then extend it and send it. Okay, this will be the sidebar, this will be the main content, so you only pass the layout the data you want to show. It allows to include error messages, and it has custom exceptions, so you can catch them and do show them in the way you want. And of course, most of the developers can use syntax I like them in their own IDs. With Twig, this is more Joomla oriented as a project, because I think that something like Twig is really needed in Joomla 4, but it's my advice. I'm not sure it's going to happen. But if we adopted Twig, we will remove lines of code that the same will apply to your own extensions. You don't have to include your own JLayout version, which is something a lot of people do. You can remove it. You stop caring about where do you are going to store the templates or the layouts, because it's a standard way that we will see later. Your layouts, if you create a module, will be here or here, and it's the same for every module, so you don't have to specify that in your module. The developers have more power because as extension developer you have the option to create function or filters that any site builder can use. Site builders can also create their own stuff at the template level or even with plugins. Of course, if you have an extension, you can use Twig, but also keep backward compatibility. It's quite easy to say in a module setting, I want to use Twig, or I want to keep the old legacy behavior. So you can keep backward compatibility quite easy. And you can also, if you use layouts, you can use the layouts inside the Twig layouts. So it's like the perfect path, because in maybe 10-30 minutes you have everything working, and you are not going to break anything to your clients. One of the things that Joomla lacks is people coming from other projects, Drupal or whatever, people that knows PHP but doesn't know Joomla. They have to learn how JLayout works. Is another barrier that we have to for them. So if you use Twig, I found that frontenders also prefer that to things like PHP. Frontenders that don't like PHP code. A lot of things can be replaced with Twig, like module groms in templates, which is just a function that will show all the modules in that position in a specific way. So you can use a Twig layout for that. And you can even run a full position with the layout. So I think it can replace a lot of stuff also in JHTML document. This is a JLayout comparison. The top one is a layout done with JLayout. It's not layout JLayout, the name official, but it's layout file. I keep it because people know it as JLayout. So the top one is the yellow layout usage, and I think it's clear that for a frontender, it's easier to use the second one when they are used to things like Smarty or Mustache or Blade. But it's cleaner the second one. And I have to say that both can live together, as I told you. We will see later, but there is a function to render a JLayout inside a Twig layout, So I'm going to change now this stuff, but I will keep using the old layout as I have to. So article date or whatever you want, you can do it, or even to use the core things. And stop using JLayout. I contributed a lot to improve JLayout. And the original plan was to create a rendering system that needed to be customized for Joomla, because we hadn't a rendering system. But it was like a first step to migrate to other complex systems like Twig, Smart, whatever. And the best thing is that I did a lot of work. I won't say all the work, but I already created an extension that you can use to integrate Twig. And I hope that everybody uses it, because I haven't created it to get money or reputation, but to avoid conflicts to the end users. When there is a user that has a template that uses Twig, like I think you think, and uses an extension that also uses Twig, there is an error because the functions are not the same. He's totally, his website is broken, just installing two extensions, and he's not able to log in anymore. And he hasn't even the option to fix it because he cannot do anything, ask someone to fix it. And with Twig, you can check the installed Twig extension, the version, and show a warning to the user and say, okay, this Twig version is not compatible, but it's your decision how to resolve that conflict, which is something that at the end it has to relay in the users, or at least give the tools to developers to know which version is installed, or what can be upgraded, or what cannot. So this is the extension I created, and it works with plugins, so everything can be not only extended. You can create your own functions or filters, but you can even change whatever you don't like. If I want that the book mode works different, you can disable that plugin and enable another the book plugin. I don't recommend it, but you can do it. Everything is working with plugins, the book, cache, everything. Joomla Twig is open source, it's free and will ever be free. You can extend it with plugins. I ensure that everything is fully tested, so you can rely on it. And ensure that your plugin is going to be always loaded. And I hope that this is some kind of agreement between the developer and me, or the extension, because if you are shipping your own version of Twig and you are replacing it with Joomla Twig, you have to invest some time. But you will have a system that is fully tested. And I think it's worth the effort. It's easy to integrate, so mainly you will remove code from your extension, and it's automatically updated with Joomla updates. So I think it has everything and only things that people use it. This is the way that you integrate it. I try to it to be the most developer experience. So you can easily remember it. You have to just load the Twig library, and you can start using it. This is how, for extension developers, how Google, for instance, show a component layout. This is a view. The login view from common users will be replaced with something like that, or could be replaced. And it will search like JLayout does, it will set for templates automatically in those places. So the end user can automatically create an override, they can do in the with PHP layout. And not even it's even better because the user can keep the same folder structure. If it were PHP layout, they will conflict. But with Twig, they have a different extension, so they can keep the old PHP layouts with new PHP Twig layouts and combine them in the way they want. The view is also in the. This is totally there is a typo there. It's exactly the same place,
it's missing, missing the template
subfolder. It's exactly in the same pages as the core layouts right now, so I wanted it to be as easy as to understand as possible. This is a module layout, which is also automatically recognized if you use that namespace, which is module. It will automatically search in those places for templates. As you can see, it's also the same places as current modules. So users will understand it easily. And also a library layout, because most of the extensions, a lot of extensions, include a library that has a shared layout between a module, can show articles in the same way in a module or a component. And if you do that, there is also support for you, and it's also in a common way that people use layouts, which is in a layouts folder inside your extension. And there is also support for plugins, and it's also the same folder structure. We don't have to explain it because, as you see, it also misses the template in the last slide. I forgot it. But it's in the same structure that Content Boats. I think it's one of the plugins that supports layout. And also at template level, there is an option, because when I started to use Twig, it was for my modules, libraries, plugins, but I found that at template level, you can replace. If you're a template developer or has a commercial template system, all the position of that template are like the perfect match for Twig blocks. So you can say, this is a block, I don't really need Joomla to say where to show modules, because I can handle my own blocks. And in fact, I think it's a way to easy the way that template developers can create things. So you can create in your own template, you can create base views and add different views, like I want this with sidebar, and it will be a base template that I provide with my extension. So if someone wants to use a form here and something here, they can do it automatically, just replacing in the override the base layout they are going to use. So the most potential is at the template level. This is how you, in your own, mainly for site builders, how they will use it to store their own layouts. You can also distribute layouts for articles, for content articles, and reuse them in all your projects as you do with PHP. Before this, I'm going to show you the documents of Jonathan to show you how plugins are done. And this is the repository. This is the repository. It uses Joomla 2, I forgot to mention it. It's quite common now. And it also includes the Twig extensions, that are common things for to deal with strings and updates and things like that. This is the repository, and also you have a link here, which is the documentation that I'm going to review with you. This is a quick start, which is pretty much what I already explained. And then there are the Joomla Twig extension already defines some global variables for us, which is common stuff that users need in all the layouts. Like when you are in a layout, you need to interact with the active application. JAB is a plugin that returns the active application, You can use it. There is an example below all the section in the documentation. I'm sure they can be improved. Right. I try to at least document everything. For you can interact with, JAB, you can interact with everything available on the factory get application, document, get current user. You can do throw it, whatever is possible with the because I'm going to show you the code for the next. this is question.
This is the extension.
It's really, it's really easy to... I know, this is in the... What function do is basically to link a tag, which in this case is JLang. What we'll do is to use the already existing JLang. I'm not doing anything here. Just say the name of the tag and say that this function will be mapped to the getInstance method of the language class. So I'm not doing anything except grabbing the existing already existing Joomla class. So it's like the perfect match. And this is the same, the JAB global variable is really representing JFactory GetApplications. You get exactly the same result. There is also JDoc for things like loading style sheets or loading JavaScript files, or even declaration. You can do exactly the same using the same methods that we are already using, but instead of using PHP, you use the JDoc.addScriptDeclaration that we saw on Alertbox. There is also JLang, which I showed you before. It's mainly to get the active language, but you can also retrieve another language passing the language tag, like to load the Spanish and show the article in another language, different than the active one. There is also JSession, because sometimes you need to display a token in the form, or even store things in your own layout that are then shown in the website. This will create a link to maybe, you can use it to create something like an AJAX query, which includes a token. Then there is JUri, which is the replacement of the original JUri that is now using namespaces, but everybody knows. And you can get the main folder, you can use JUri root, base, whatever you're using, JUri class, can be done. Then the JUser global variable stores the active Joomla users. So you can check if a user is a guest, and if it's loaded, show its name, its email, do whatever you want, or display a login form, a login link, whatever. And those are the global variables. Remember that you can also define your own variables if you have stuff in your template system or your modules, and you need a constant or whatever you need, you can do it through plugins. As you have seen, the plugins are really empty things. This is the class definition, but the plugin, all the plugins, everything can be done with one line of code. So I try to ease how people could interact and make it as easy as possible to do interaction, because I'm sure that I miss things. There are things that people use, but I don't use them. So I want that anybody can say, okay, let's add this plugin. I think this is a global plugin that everybody can use. Or I will keep it with my extension because it's something special that I use. But you can do it with one line. This is a function. But here, this is actually how the global variable is defined. So this is mapping this variable to the application. We could do something like here, I map, I don't know, form, get instance, for instance, which is the way to load a form. I'm sure this doesn't make sense, but we could do it, and it will be one line of code. So that's pretty cool. And then you can also add filters. Like, I'm going to show it. This is a filter, and it does what I explained before. You have a variable, then a tube, I don't know how it's said that symbol, and then to array, which converts cast a variable to an array. It will be used with something like I have here my users, and or users to array could be used like this. Yep. Like this in a template. So let's review the functions. This is one of the functions that most people will use. This is JHTML. It's used now to load tokens. I think it's even used for tabs. I don't recommend you that you use it for tabs, but someone decided it was a cool way of using it. But for forms, it's pretty unique. This is JLang, which is different than the JLang. The global variable stores the active language, and this is the function. So they have the same name, but the other one is a variable, and this is a function that will load the language that you want. So I'm here, even if the website is in English, I'm loading the Spanish language, displaying the tag. This could be a language selector to switch between two languages. So this could be done. And this is one of the most interesting things for Joomla and for extension developers. This is how you would use an existing JLayout render JLayout layout inside Twig. It's preparing the data, probably you already have the data, and preparing it, and then just creating an instance of a layout and rendering it. You can even call layout debug, and it goes to, it will automatically render. You have to add the filter, the raw filter, because as I told you before, everything is automatically escaping. So if you want to render things like a form or HTML, globally. If layout, all the layout stuff needs to be used with RAW. And also URLs, if you don't escape that, if you don't use RAW data, you will get the URL sanity set. Which is a cool thing. It's you have to do things right. And this is, I also created a debug function for layout, so you can use it directly. This is like a replacement of the static JLayout calls that are shown in the core. I think I'm going to search it. We will have time, so I'm going to search it. In the CMS, we have things like edit association. No, this one is not. Things like this. This is calling an static method to render a layout, which is cool. I created it. No. it's a fast way to show a layout and its content. So it's cool that we keep that for extension developers, and this is JLayout debug and JLayout render are pretty much the same. This is exactly the same and running this command, and debug is the same than running this other command, JLayout debug, and that will show this layout is the name of the layout is this, and it's going to search in these folders for layouts. Is the debug information that you already have with JLayout. So JLayout is not a problem to start using Twig. I think they are perfect match. You have years to remove your own layouts. And there is also JPosition, which is I found that creation when I forgot to comment when this was born. I was working for a company with Noemi and Christian. And it's a big company, and there is people that does front-end stuff, and there is people like me that do back-end stuff, and we most of the time fight. They ask things, and we say, no, I'm not going to do that. but they want it. And we have to somehow create a line, a red line to say, okay, this is where my job ends, and this is where your job starts. And with Twig, it's quite easy, like with JLayout. Front-end developers don't need to understand anything about PHP. And if they need something, they came and say, Roberto, I'd like to display a module here, and I don't have how to. So I had to create something for that. I think it's cool because it's born from front-end requirements and it's easy for backenders to provide those things. And this is one of those things. This is rendering the template position with the name position 8. And again, with one line of code, we can replace the J module, or J, I don't know how it's said. Then there is profiler, which is something that most people don't know. The core comes with a thing called JProfiler, which is useful when you have performance issues. You can create an instance of a profiler, in this case I'm creating it with the name Twig, and you can set marks, and it will tell you in that moment how much memory it was consumed. And how much time was spent to reach that point. So if I have between those calls, if I have something that is consuming a lot of resources, it will tell me that between that call and the next call, maybe it was 16 seconds. So when you have a template system that is external with Twig, we had issues in the company. In PHP, you can use JProfiler, but in Twig, we could not use it. So with this, I can map all the model, loading stuff like articles, and use the same profiler in the template, so I can have a full trace of what's happening in the page. Like loading articles, displaying an article, and when I display the tag, there is a rise in the time. So that's where the problem is. And I recommend you to use it, and it's basically an instance of Joomla Profiler, which is a great tool that nobody knows. Then there is JRoot, which everybody knows, to create URLs to stuff for articles or whatever you need. And it works exactly, again, it's a version of the already existing class, and doing anything is the equivalent or the root most common used method. So you just have to replace the old PHP call with the new JRoot call. When I was working with switching over templates to Twig, I found that I was mainly removing code. Remove the PHP opening tags, and it also comes with another benefit. If you use things like code style validation, coding standards, when you scan a layout, you will get a lot of errors because the Joomla coding standard does not support things like opening tags in the same line and closing the tag in the same line. Because it's not intended to be used in layouts. With Twig, Joomla won't detect that there is PHP code there, so it will pass all the tests. So it's another benefit for Joomla. Then there is JTEX, which is a replacement of the language string translator. There is JTEX and JTEX Sprint F, which are the ones that are more used in the core. And all the functions in the documentation, if you look here in the top side, there are the variables that they support and the default values that they get, which are exactly the same as in the core. These are the parameters and what it returns. It's crazy. Then there is Sprintf, which, well, you can directly replace and save the code. Then there is your query, that is to create something to manage different URLs, or to create, when you are on a layout, in extreme cases, you need to create something like the same URL that I have, but I'm going to add another variable, query bar. to save page 2 or page 2, to whatever, remove the item ID, which is something that a lot of extension developers are doing to avoid conflicts. They remove the item ID, or even changing it. I'm going to replace the item ID, all the occurrences of specified item ID, I will replace them with the item ID one. And then if you execute this method, we can see it later if I have time, how they work. And also the extension that I commented, there are, which is this one. There is a layout. This is a very basic layout that is web. That is showing articles, and as you see, is quite clean. There is no PHP code, and this could be wrapped in something like a library, where I say, okay, I want to show articles in a grid, and then from the model, call that layout inside the library, because it's just an include call in Twig, and say, I will pass you those articles, and you will display them in a grid. So it's really powerful. A lot of things can be done with the layout, so it's not something new, but it's easier because if you learn how to use Twig layouts in a library model, if you learn the namespaces, which are quite easy to understand, if you learn how to use the quick start thing, then inside that Twig layout you can use the include tag and say, I'm going to show it. This is the model that I'm showing in the browser, but if I wanted here to include another layout, I could do something like include, and give it the layout to be included. So this will automatically load another layout from my layout. I can do something like with, I was talking before with an English guy, and he was telling me that he needed like options for layouts, which is something that you can change, but here is the font that is quite easy, you can say, show sidebar and then true false. You can have a same layout, but display with a difference, or you can even, if you don't use anything like this, it will use all the existing variables in this layout will be existing in the included layout, so you could even do something like, set show sidebar equal to false, and inside the layout you will detect that you can, that the option need to be included. So just quite easy to have a filter place for our layout, which is something that I missed, that extension developers do, because maybe you have something that is showing an slider, but if you provide those direct layouts for sideboarders, you will find that they can maybe display the same slider in different places. So if it can be done with one line, you only have to explain those are the layouts, and this is how we call them, and what you get, you can even show the grid layout with how is name, how is called, and stuff like that. Then there is the filters, which is basic filtering, because filters are something, this is easy to do. So I'm just giving an initial integration, mainly because the JRY casting, which is basically doing nothing, but cast a variable to array. And then initialize, which is needed for some extent cases for the dealing with sessions. Session data is serialized. So you want to retrieve some session value, you maybe need to serialize it. So this is the way it's done. You can distribute Joomla Twig with your extension. If you have a package, you can include it, the zip file, which is in the download section. In the releases section here, there are all the releases, and there is a zip file, which is the one thing that you can install and save it in your Joomla website. It supports automatical upgrades, updates, so the end user will say, oh, there is a new version, and I can install it. To integrate Joomla SIM with your extension, Joomla Twig with your extension, I think the best could be to create a package. Or to just show a message, to install this, you need Joomla Twig. And maybe a download link or something. I'm working with a solution that works not only for Joomla Twig, but for any extension. You can say, this extension has these dependencies. So then user, and you can provide those dependencies in your, I'm going to show it, because we have time. This is a company project. This is my vision about how dependencies could work in Joomla, because I had things in my company. I wanted to use Joomla Twig, I wanted to use Joomla Entity, different things that I have released, and it was not possible in Joomla to check dependencies. So I'm basically creating a method that in your installer you can set things like this, and it will automatically upgrade if the version installed is not the version specified here. It's a regular expression. It will automatically upgrade if possible, if it's compatible, but it's not the version needed. It will do it. It's pretty much like composer to us, but in a custom way. So I hope that this is done in next week or by the end of next week. And I'm not sure how I'm going to release it, because it can be used for any project. I'm not sure. But I will add a document in the documentation how to integrate Joomla Twig with your extension. And I think that's it. If anybody has some questions. Yeah, to load automatically, but JForm is loaded in models, because it needs to add include path. So you have to load a form that is there. So maybe when it's added, we need to somehow tell it where are the models that we want to use. It can be, it could be cool. But also it gets the data from the session. So not sure. It's maybe.
Is there a way to have like compressed output? Because whenever you use read or play or whatever template, you end up with many tabs, return characters, switches.
Many tabs
with return characters?
Yeah, the indentation. So you have like these and then you have the other.
And this is also I forgot to comment. The cache and the back. Plugins. There are two plugins that automatically enable. I'm not here. There are two plugins that are automatically, Twig automatically compiles those templates into PHP code. And it's also the next time you can even just show the compile if it's not changed, and you get that out of the box. You don't need to do anything. It's not the same thing. You are talking something about Maybe beautifully.
No, the thing is that whenever you buy something, either PHP or whatever, the HTML that you get is like formatted with spaces and there. And actually, what you want to send to the browser is compressed, like div, close the div, and then the next div without space.
I think that's the best way. Let's check it. Maybe here. Here are the compile files. And this is what you get. Because this is the source, but as you see, this is a small. I don't have big. It's a special. I'm not sure.
You see, it's echo slash key. That means there's a tab there.
Is there a way to remove that and get everything compressed?
So I don't think so.
Maybe with that tweak, I don't see something like that. Maybe you can break this. Forecasting, if forecasting, data, I'm not sure, it's possible. Forecasting, if forecasting, maybe that's a JFrom. Maybe if done right, I'm sure. So there is a question here about performance against Joomla templates. I actually did some benchmarks for my company, because it's hard when you have the same data, created a view, but you have to isolate really if it's the template system that is causing the delay, so you have to really run a fair benchmark to really say that. Okay, this is the real performance with JLayout, and this is exactly the same machine with the Twig. I did one when I improved JLayout, I did a benchmark with all the template methods, so I think it could be interesting and could be a way for people to adopt Twig, so I will definitely do it. That's it. So thank you, everybody. I hope you understand.